それとな、ルディ、一言言いたいことがあったんだが。
何ですか？
いや、これは今はいいか。宿に戻ったらにしよう。
何ですか？そういうの、死亡フラ
グ。ルディ、俺は今、二振りの剣を使っている。以前は一振りで十分だったが、今はこの二振りがないとしっくり来ない。どちらも愛着があるし、役割が違う。
Happy Sunday morning, friends. There was nothing, nothing I was more excited to do than this morning waking up to come and watch Mashoko Tensei with you guys. Like, there was just nothing. Do you guys remember that feeling waking up on, like, Saturday morning and, you know, you had school the prior day. You're like, I'm gonna get up really early on Saturday because the new episode of Pokemon is coming out or the new episode of whatever you're wanting to watch is coming out. Or maybe it's the opposite. Do you guys remember staying up really late to watch Toonami because maybe the new episode of Yu Yu Hakusho was coming out, or maybe you're looking forward to the episode of Gundam or DBZ or whatever it was. Like, that's the feeling I had this morning with waking up. I was like, oh shit, like, yo, let's go, Mashoko Tensei, Roxy. I was like, Roxy. And I was like, yeah, let's go to my room, Roxy. You know, and I was like, yo, I'm like, let me get my coffee. I was like, bing, coffee. I was like, let's go. I'm ready to watch this with Roxy. Now, here's the thing. So, this episode was awesome. In comparison though, to last week, I would say it was... I can understand how some would say... And I want to make sure, this is not for me. For me, this episode was all filled with Roxy. And she's my... If you guys didn't know, she's my favorite character of the show. And because it was full of Roxy, like, this was like a 12 out of 10 for me. But I can understand those who might come in and, you know, just comparing apples for apples or apples to oranges, right? Last week and this week are a little bit different vibes and a little bit different. And I think that they will suit the taste slightly or the palate slightly different to each individual. So for me, I preference this week. I think they're both masterpieces, but I preference this week. But I can understand how some would... come from last week to this week and be like, oh, this episode wasn't as good. And I think if that's your opinion, then that is completely okay. Now, one thing I did want to mention and say, and by the way, those feelings are totally okay, but I love this week. It was all about Roxy and her her feelings with Rudy. Anyway, I'm gonna step back real quick. So last week's episode ended with, you know, Rudy coming in and being the big hero with Roxy and basically fulfilling one of her really long time dreams. You know, when she had spoken with Alina Lise before, you know, she had kind of like depicted her vision of what her savior, what her future boyfriend or her future partner spouse would do. And, you know, her whole entire vision is tackling a labyrinth together, but, you know, being in some kind of dire straits and this like skinny boy, you know, basically just Rudy comes and saves her and they fall in love and they go tackle a labyrinth together. And basically, like, she's living that dream. That is exactly what happened to her. And then she got Rudy to commit to going and tackling a labyrinth, just them two, you know, a small labyrinth, just them two as a really cool adventure. And she was like over the moon about that. And I was like, that is the cutest thing ever. But to take a step back, one of the things that a lot of you guys expressed to me last week in the comments was being unfulfilled with the Roxy and Rudy reuniting. And I wanted to talk about that just for like 2 seconds and, you know, say that I hope this week you're feeling a little bit better about that. But I could definitely understand that the way that you guys explained it to me, for those who are very familiar with Source, you know, a couple of you went into really good detail, you know, without spoiling, but you kind of went into detail about like how the struggles that Roxy went through and kind of how we got to this point and kind of Rudy's magnanimous entrance was supposed to be very a lot different than what we got. And what we got was we got a lot, but we got a lot without context about, like, you know, with her being stuck for a month and how long it truly, you know, took her to get, you know, took them to get to her. And, you know, the way that the show does time is very specific because they only have so much time to tell us this really long, drawn-out story. But I'm hoping you guys felt a little bit better this week because they did start off the episode with her kind of trekking through the labyrinth for a month or a little bit over a month. And it kind of showed her going through the different teleportation stages and marking the walls and her, you know, keep her kind of cycle of keeping coming back to this one specific spot that she's marked over and over and over again. And it showed her how she finally decided to take the leap into the, you know, into the abyss, or into this other unknown teleportation circle that she thought may be a trap. But she's like, I got to get out of here. You know, I have aspirations. I can't die. So she takes that leap. And that leap is what ends up leading her into the area that Rudy ended up finding her. Now, unfortunately, we didn't get the complete scene of Rudy's second sense to go and get her. But what we did get was Paul explaining to Roxy on how Rudy, like, you know, and I quote very... don't quote me one for one, but I quote that he basically said that Rudy said that he was like, I can feel my goddess, and he just broke through walls, like, bah, 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 bah. He just, like, broke through walls to go and get her. Even Geese was like, yo, bro, you don't break no more walls, bro. We don't know if this can hold up, and we might die, so, you know, chill on that. And I love the explanation of it, and I love everything, and I just want to keep gushing about it. A couple of things before I gush more about the Rudy and Roxy reuniting is Paul continues to be one of my favorite characters of the show. He's been a very complex character. He's also, you know, a very struggling father. He's made a lot of just, you know, not great decisions in his life. And, you know, that's led to a lot of different things. The reuniting with Rudy, just a lot of different things. And at the end of the day, you know, I love Paul as a character. I think he's an imperfect father. But the thing about that is, I think every parent is imperfect in a different way. Everybody has messed up. Everybody will mess up. Now, the level of importance, you know, or impact on the scale of how that affects their children is different for everybody, you know. But, like, I think he's an imperfect father, but that's kind of what makes him a really complex and really interesting and really cool character. One of my favorite moments this episode, though, was Rudy had complimented Paul, and, you know, Paul had, you know, he had just, you know, took down, like, a monster or whatever, and Rudy was like, hey, you know, hey, by the way, like, have you gotten, like, a lot more powerful? It seems like, you're up there, bro. And he's like, no, if anything, Rudy, I've gotten weaker. And he walks away, but he walks away just cheeseballing, because Alita Lee goes like, yo, Paul, you, like, he just like, like, he feels over the moon at the compliments that are thrown at Rudy, and he feels over the moon by the way that he's able to answer those questions. So I was like, that is just such, that's such a really cool father-son, you know, experience and back and forth. And it was just so cool to see Paul in that light of just him relishing. And he had already done it before, but he just, you know, relishing in Rudius's compliments. He just, like, I don't think there's any better feeling, you know, especially as a parent, you know what I mean? There's no better feeling than when you're displaying something heroistic to your kid. I think that's just so cool. Later on in the episode, too, towards the tail end, before they know they find the secret entrance and stuff, Paul begins to look at Roxy because, you know, Roxy and Rudy have been getting a lot closer, and he knows for a fact that Rudy just loves Roxy. And if anything, there's the only thing you need to see is the actions that he took to get to her this episode, and the worry. And, like, it's extremely evident that he loves Roxy, okay? And Paul is contemplating on talking to him about the whole Sylphie and having a wife and not telling her that you got a wife, and you know, maybe expressing his feelings to her. And, like, he's ready to kind of have that talk with him about, like, you know, just because you love pizza doesn't mean you can't love fried chicken. But he does it in the words of swords. He's like, hey, you know, I got these two swords now, and before I only had one sword, and I loved the one sword. I was like, that's my sword. But then I got the other sword, and now I'm like, I love this sword, and now I can't be without either of my swords, you know? So just know it's okay to find a new sword and to be like, I need both swords in my life. And the way that he does the conversation, I was like, my dude, Paul, man, like, this is my guy right here. And I was like, I think it might have went over Rudy's head, you know, but, like, that's my dude, you know. Last thing I'll say, because I'm going like close to time here, or what I consider time, is just the different scenes throughout the rest of the episode with Rudy and Roxy getting closer, with her reading a book, with him contemplating on how small she is and how she would sit in his lap, with Roxy being very embarrassed multiple times at just like staring at Rudy, and like her leading in and be in, or him leading in and being that perfect image of what she imagines, you know, taking that leap looks like. As she's described before, you know, her reading the book, her looking at Rudy, seeing him in action, and just like all those things, you know, is just really, really awesome. So I'll cut it off there, and I'll just say that I love their reuniting, and I thought this episode was just incredible. 12 out of 10, freaking awesome episode. I'll see you guys next week for the next episode of Mushoku Tensei. My friends, stay up, stay clean, stay beautiful, and I'll see you then. All right, peace out.